Hello, I'm Anthony Hughes, and in this video, I'll be showing you the improvements we've made to playing techniques in Dorico 3, the advanced music notation software from Steinberg. It's now possible for playing techniques to show their duration using a continuation line, and you can group two or more playing techniques together, showing the transition and ensuring automatic alignment. Let's see how this works. Now, when I invoke the playing techniques popover on a selection using Shift P as normal and type a direction such as sul tasto, Dorico indicates the duration of the technique by way of this continuation line, which is editable when selected in right mode by way of dragging the handles. You can show a transition from one technique to another by typing them both in the popover, separated by an arrow, which we type here as a hyphen immediately followed by the closing angled bracket. You can see how Dorico displays the transition with an arrow. You can create these playing technique groups during note input. With the caret showing, invoke the playing technique's popover and type the initial direction followed by the arrow. Press return and continue to enter notes. Then open the popover again and enter the closing direction. If there is no second technique and you want only to end the continuation line, type a question mark into the popover. Finally, you can group together existing playing techniques by selecting them and choosing Edit Playing Techniques, Group Playing Techniques. And you can get to that from the right-click context menu as well. This is how you would group together playing techniques created from the panel. Notice how the grouped playing techniques are vertically aligned and stay as such when one or more of them have to move. There are commands to remove playing techniques from a group in the same menu. Let's switch to engrave mode and open the engrave menu choosing playing techniques. The editor now contains a new tab of controls all about these new continuation lines, whether a technique uses them and their design, meaning you can now edit existing playing techniques to use continuation and transition lines, or indeed create your own. You'll notice many playing techniques now utilize the new line option as a continuation type, and the default design of a solid line with inward pointing hook can be changed to one of many different options, including dashed lines, wavy lines, and so on. The same goes for the transition lines, which are solid with an arrowhead by default. You can also override individual cases in the properties panel. When you fine-tune the position of a playing technique in engrave mode, any continuation or transition lines will stay attached, and you can also edit the placement of the lines themselves. I do hope you found this video helpful. If you have, please click the thumbs up button below to let me know you've liked it, and subscribe to the Dorico YouTube channel today to see many more videos like this one. I'm Anthony Hughes. Thanks for watching.